Good morning, students. A very refreshing morning to all of you. So again, we are back with your accounts lecture. As yesterday, we have discussed about the accounting cycle, the process of accounting. So today, we are going to discuss about users of accounting information, that who gets benefit from the financial statements so prepared, why are they prepared, who are the ones who need them, and to whom they are most favorable. So we are following the T.S. Garhiwal's double entry bookkeeping book for your study part. Let us first go through the learning objectives of users of financial statements. That is, to outline the variety of accounting roles, internal and external, to a business with relevant examples. So in today's lecture, you are going to come across with the following key terms. Listen to the video properly, only then you are able to answer these key terms. First is merchandising, management. Third is potential investors, employees, SEC and Chamber of Commerce. Before discussing the topic, let us first go through the chapter at a quick look. So as we all have covered introduction, bookkeeping, meaning, process, differences, events, objectives, and today we are going to discuss about users of accounting information. Hey, all of you are students of Holy Heart Presidency School. These days, due to novel COVID-19, you all are staying at home and school is providing you with online education system and they are providing you with school links. Okay, now let me give you a very simple example. Now, when you open YouTube, you go for Holy Heart Schools, you subscribe and find the video related to your subject, your class. So, being a student of Holy Heart, if you view the video, then you will be categorized as internal user. Similarly, if the same videos, the same links are viewed by others, say the students of Millennium School, Sacred Heart School, DBS School, then those users will be considered as external users. So this is a very simple example. Now we will connect this example with a company. Okay, now tell me, you all must be very fond of wearing shoes, branded shoes. So students are very much familiar with the different brands available for wearing shoes. So one of the very famous brand, I suppose, Nike. People used to wear their t-shirts, people used to wear their footwear also. Let us take an example of a retail firm or a merchandising business. Now, what is merchandising? That is retail business. One who produces and sells of its own, in which production firm, the manufacturing firm and the selling firms are same. That is called a merchandising business. So we have many examples of such business houses, like we have automobile companies, clothes manufacturers, cell phone makers, computers operators. Say Dell Computers is the best example, who produces and sells it at its own retail outlet. And now, as we were talking about Nike, so these days Nike is written as Nike ID because Nike has its own studio. So it mainly deals in clothes and shoes. In 2007, its first studio was opened at Nike Town in New York. It is an American multinational corporation. So Nike ID is a MNC. So suppose that you are the manager of a sporting goods store that sells Nike shoes. What I am saying that you are a manager of a sporting goods store that sell Nike shoes. Now, tell me, being a manager of a showroom who sell a very branded and a reputed footwear brand, whom you have to interact with in your day-to-day operations. You have customers, you have taxpayers, you have suppliers. Other than that, you also have competitors, you have investors, you have to deal with the officers, the internal auditors, government policies, general public. So to all those, being a manager, you have to interact with are called users of accounting information. They are interested in your business because they want to be a part. So we have gathered information now that
as we were doing the process of accounting yesterday, so we were discussing there that first of all we have to collect the information, the data, and in this way when data collection is completed, it is assessed through various stages of accounting. Then accounting reports are prepared. These reports are the result of accounting process and they are transferred to the users in two forms. One is internal, other is external. Internal users are those users who used it for effective operating. So as we were discussing the example of Nike shoe store, a retail store for shoes. So what is the possibility in that? That the manager will use it for more efficiency of its operations. And if you talk about the external users, they get a real picture of the financial statement of the organizations. So who will be the external users there? The customers, the consumers, lenders, creditors, taxpayers, press, media. So who are they? They are the external users because they want to get accurate position, the presentation of a particular company. So now we will discuss about the users of accounting information, internal and external, one by one. So for internal purpose, we have business owners, we have investors, we have managers, employees. For external, we have lenders, suppliers, customers, tax authorities. Now first of all, business owners. The person who invests in the business are the internal users. The one who is investing has all interest in the working of the business, in its profits. Next is investor. The person who is engaged in advancing some money, the one who advances money, that is known as investor, or the person who lends some money for the sake of interest, that is known as investor. Next is manager. The person who has been appointed by the top management to take care of all the activities under the hierarchy of flow of authority, that person is known as a manager. Now the next is employees. The staff, the faculty of the organization, or that performs according to the requirement of the company and towards the accomplishment of the goal, that is known as employee. On the other hand, if we talk about external users, we have lenders. So lenders are the persons from whom we borrow money, from whom we raise funds so that we can have more availability of cash as and when needed. Next is suppliers. So they are the persons who provide the raw products, the finished products, the products ready for resale. So they are the one who make the business happening because they provide you with the inventory, they provide you with the stock. And moreover, we have customers. So customers are the king of the society. They are the ultimate point at which the organization has to reach. More the number of customers, more will be the profits. Next is tax authorities. Taxpayers
are the most important part of an organization, because we have to comply with the government rules and regulations, and we have to pay tax according to the prescribed authority as laid down by the standards. So the internal and external users collectively make a broad line on which the organization revolves. Without internal and external users, there is no fun of preparing financial statements. We are preparing financial statements just because for the sake of satisfaction of internal and as well as external users. So internal users are that individual who runs, manages, operates the daily activities of the inside area of organization. Managerial accounting identifies, measures, analyzes and communicates the financial information needed management to plan, control and evaluate a company's operations for the internal users. So, on the other hand, the external users can be creditors, they can be investors, government, trading partners, regulatory agencies, international standardization agencies, journalists, internal users. So they are owners, directors, managers, and employees of the company. External users are those individuals who take interest in the account information of an organization, but they are not the part of organization's administrative process. They are not involved in working of the business, yet they play a very important role in the progress of a company because they give money and they help in generating money. Accounting's goal is to provide necessary information for the management. So when information is given to the management, they are called internal users. External users have a direct or indirect interest in accounting information. So the management we called as internal user, and the direct or indirect interest keening persons are called external users. For their sake, the accounting information is published and prepared. Financial accounting is the process for the preparation of financial reports of the enterprise for use by both internal and external parties. For example, labor unions, tax authorities, consumers, SEC, Chamber of Commerce, they all are external users. Other than that, international standardization agencies, journalists, all are examples of external users. But the most important external users are creditors and investors. They are the regular examples among all other present external users because they are the ones without whom the business cannot be run. Anyone outside the managing radius of an economic entity is entrusted in the financial information. It is defined as external user. So one who is not in the managing part in day-to-day working, who is not actively involved in the business, but they are entrusted in the financial position that how the business is operating, are known as external users. Okay, coming back to the same example as we have discussed in the starting. For example, a MBA student looking for financial information on Google. So what is that MBA student called? Internal user or external? So he will be an external user of accounting information of Google. He is outside the managing radius of economic entity. Now you know there are crores, millions of people who are using Google every day. They are taking information out of it. Information is given to them. Information is shown on Google, but they are not in the managing activity of any related topic they are searching for. They are only taking information. They want to take a picture of the activity they are interested in. So that's why they are external users. So what we can conclude here, that accounting information is required for establishing good accounting control on the production, on the prices, on the consumers, and it is ensured that all the users, whether they are internal or external, they must not get exploited by any false information. They just want to see the business running. Sometimes some users take substantial interest in the working of the business, but others do not contribute to the economy in any way. Thus, financial accounting provides useful information to various groups for the purpose of decision making. Hope the concept of users of internal and external is now clear. For better clarity of the concept, do follow the given link so that you can have a hold of the topic. Moreover, read the PDF and go through the explanation as given in the books. Only then you are able to answer the questions. First one, who are the users of accounting? What accounting information do the users need and why? Answer all the new key terms discussed above, the key terms which I have mentioned. You have to answer all those key terms in your FAIR notebook. Thank you.